to do again? Welcome back to a new YouTube video. Today is Wednesday, August 17th, and I am back with a highly anticipated video. I know I said I would film this content for you guys like 4 weeks ago, but I'm doing it today, so y'all gonna rock with it today. Today's video content will be about acquiring brand deals, tips and tricks on how to find them, what should I do when reaching out to brands. I'm also gonna give you guys more detail about the Panasonic deal that I acquired. How did I even get that brand? How did that start? I'm also gonna show you the Panasonic product that they sent me because I finally got it. It just came in the mail like 15 minutes ago. So without further ado, let's get started. So the Panasonic deal. I look like a fucking hobo. Let me go switch my fit real quick and then I'll be right back. All right, that's better. So securing the Panasonic deal. So essentially what happened was I got contacted by one of the brand reps or brand marketing reps for Panasonic. She was like, hey, you amongst a few other creators have been on our radar essentially for promoting some of our Panasonic products and we'd like to select you. Are you interested? I was like, sure, of course. Like, what the fuck? Why not? From there, I basically was put through like a waiting period while they went through their selection process. And about 3.5 weeks later, they contacted me again and said, hey, like, we want to select you to market one of our products that we choose. So the best part about this was I was selected. The worst part about it was I didn't get to choose what product I was promoting. It was more so like they're running like a test run to see what my analytics look like, to create any shock or any purchases from my area. And if so, then they're going to continue to work for me or work with me. So they sent me some headphones, which I have right here that I haven't opened yet. My game plan for this content, I'm going to do another cleaning type reel. And in the reel, I'm going to put the headphones on and then, you know, essentially it'll be a whole thing. It'll be a whole like whole little vibey thing. So let me show you guys what the headphones are. So these are the Panasonic Technics headphones. Alexa built in, high resolution audio, Bluetooth, the whole nine. These are the headphones right here. Boom. If you guys can get like a good view of that. But yeah, these are the headphones. I'm not gonna actually open this box yet just because I wanna do an unboxing video, and I'm gonna throw the unboxing video inside the like the actual content that I film. So again, it'll be like a cleaning video. I'm gonna essentially like start cleaning and think like, damn, like I need to start vibing. Then I'm gonna grab the headphones, boom, 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 open them up, put it in my ear, and then I'm gonna fucking go, you know, go crazy type shit. So that's my idea. Whenever I do drop it, which I have 4 days to post this content, so I'll probably film this tomorrow. So as soon as I do, I want you guys to go check my Instagram out, and I'll be able to post, or y'all have already posted the content for the headphones. But what I wanted to talk to you guys about is how to secure your own brand deals. So like, there's three or four ways to secure brand deals. I'm also gonna go into like a sub subject about making money as a content creator as well, because there's other ways you can make money as a content creator outside of brand deals. But if you're interested in trying to secure brand deals from like clothing brands or just like anything in general, my main, at the time at least, my main priority or like my main need for wanting to get brand deals was the free clothes. Like I live in LA, bro. It's fucking super expensive. I live in California. I don't even say LA. I live in California and everything in California is expensive. So my thing is like, damn, if I could secure brand deals, I can get free clothes and that'd be lit. So essentially what I did was, I first and foremost, I recognized the niche that I wanted to promote content for. So again, I talked about that in one of my previous videos about like understanding the platform and all of the bullshit. But again, you have to recognize what niche you are, like you're in. I chose the fashion niche. I chose like the sporty fashion, you know, the clean niche. That's just what I like. That's how I normally dress. So why not? Like again, these shorts I got from a brand called Gifted Culture. Shout out Gifted Culture. Again, they found me through my content and That's how partnerships work. So there's a couple routes that I've taken that I guess I'll share with you guys. The first, the social media marketing agencies that are available. There's hundreds of them. I'm not even gonna tell you which ones there are. I'll tell you which ones I've used and I still currently use. The one I use primarily is called Collapster. Collapster allows you to create a profile and essentially gives you the opportunity to put your own rates on what you charge for certain types of content. If you want a story post, if you're just doing one reel or you want photos or product, whatever you do, you know, Collapster allows you to create your own profile with your own media kit. And essentially what they do is brands can contact you if they have a need for something that they can afford, you know, within their budget. They say like, hey, we want to work with you because you charge X amount of dollars for this type of content or for this amount of content. Do you accept? After you accept, Then they send you 50% deposit of what they owe you for the prices that you provided. Then they send you whatever gear, whatever products that they're supposed to send you. You create the content, you send them the content, they send you the other half of the bread. Super transactional, super easy. Another way to do it is through We Sponsored. So We Sponsored essentially is the same thing, but they give you a long list of actual, like kind of well-known brands that have products that you can apply for. So for instance, if I wanted to find a Panasonic on We Sponsor, I could find Panasonic on We Sponsor, and they have items and products on there that you can actually select to apply for brand deals, for partnerships, for sponsorships, for whatever you want to do. So We Sponsored and Collapse are probably two of the most common or like well-known apps that I know of. A few of my friends put me on a few other ones that work. They're really beneficial, but again, they require you to, one, create a media kit. What a media kit is essentially you go over your analytics. So for instance, my analytics, I guess I can show you guys this because I'm super transparent with who I am and my socials. My analytics on Instagram, at least. So currently I am sitting at 25,300 followers on Instagram. Damn, I'm actually taking forever to load. My account reaches up and towards 511,000 accounts per day. And it shows like your followers and all that other nonsense on there. So again, if you've upgraded your Instagram profile to a content creator, like a business profile, you have access to the insights for your page, for your content, so on and so forth. It tells you where the content is being watched at most, by what age, by what gender, and all that nonsense. So again, create a media kit, go take your analytics, go take all the brands that you've worked with. Don't put any just random brand in there. Put the brands that people want to see. So for instance, for me, I've worked with brands like Billabong, with Thrasher, Billionaire Boys Club, Adidas. I've worked with brands all over the place. And now Panasonic, that I can put in my media kit and say, hey, I've worked with these well-known brands. That content did these numbers. These are my prices, and that is a media kit. You can go ahead and type that up in an email. You can draft it, throw your little photo on it, throw like a couple example of videos or whatever. Honestly, copy and paste and send that media kit with a nice description of who you are and your niche and what you do and what you can offer to a brand, because again, we want to be a valuable asset to these companies. And just note like, hey, that's what I have to offer. Are you interested in a partnership or like a sponsorship or like any sort of collaboration? Because I would love to be an asset to your company. And likelihood, I mean, you'll probably hear back from someone and say no, or like, you know, yes, or, you know, and that's essentially one of the fastest ways to kind of get a brand deal is like outreach, taking what you've done and what you've created and who you've worked with and putting that in the faces of all the brands and all the companies you want to work with. If you don't want to go ahead and create a profile and all the nonsense, you still need a media kit. So let me just say this for starters, whatever you choose to do, whatever route you choose to take, you still need to create a media kit because you still need to know what you can offer to a brand. You want to be able to say, hey, I'm a valuable asset because boom, you know, let's work together. So if you don't feel like doing that, then you can go the direct message approach, which again, may or may not work. It kind of depends on what brand you're reaching out to and how you decide to reach out to them. But essentially, I'll give you a great example. So let's just say Sally Joe wants to work with Yeezy. The first thing Sally Joe should do is go to LinkedIn, type in Yeezy's brand. From there, you should be able to find like the marketing department consultant. You should be able to find the social media department, whatever the case may be. Find their contact info. Don't send Yeezy a direct email. Send whoever works for their social media, content creation, their marketing department. Send them a message and say, hey, look, this is what I have to offer. Boom. You know, you have all your insights, your media kit here available. These are my rates. I would love to work with you. From there, one of two things can happen. One, they don't even reply. Because again, you're sending someone a direct message or an email. You don't know how many direct messages or emails that person is getting from content creators. Let's just be real. I'm just, you know, I think real blunt and real straightforward. Like that's, you know, but let's just say, because I'm a positive thinker, they do reply back to you. So they have access to actually see your page. So let's just say Sally Joe's popping. You know, Sally Joe sends Yeezy a DM. They open it. They say, who the fuck is Sally Joe? Let me go to her page. Boom. Sally Joe's page is busting. She got millions on millions of views. She's got followers. She got great engagement. She has affiliate links, and she shows that people are buying the stuff that she promotes. So boom, Sally Joe would acquire that brand deal just because A plus B equals C, and it makes sense for Yeezy to try to get more out of Sally Joe. You feel me? So what I'm trying to say is the route that isn't kind of content creator portal-ish is the direct contact or direct message method, where you know you find someone who's associated with the business or with the brand who works in the realm of social media and sending them a message or sending them an email. And again, I have to make this as clear as possible because I actually ignored this advice until I took it from somebody else. You have to create a media kit because brands want to see how valuable you can be to them. They don't care about what you look like. They don't care. I mean, they do. They don't care about how many followers you have. They don't care about all that bullshit, but they have to know that you can be a valuable asset to them. That's why when I said in that video, 4, 5, whatever, how many ever videos ago, that value is important because value is what's going to keep your audience engaged. And when an outsider is looking in at your page, they're going to see like, oh, damn, like Sally Joe. Sally Joe's followers all fuck with her. They all understand that Sally Joe is an influencer. She's going to promote products that they want, and they're going to engage and communicate. And you know what I'm saying? So that's, so again, building a media kit is super duper important. My third tip and my subject to either acquiring brand deals or just creating an extra stream of income from content creation. Let's use Sally Joe again as an example because Sally Joe is a big homie. Let's just say Sally Joe doesn't want to go through the content creator portal. She doesn't want to set that up. She doesn't want to go through the direct messaging route either. She just doesn't feel like sending emails out and sending DMs. She doesn't care about that. But she wants to use her platform to sell something to her audience. It could be something digital. It could be something that's, you know, tangible. It doesn't matter. I'm going to go ahead and put something out for my users and for my followers and my subscribers here. I'm taking my actual social media handle, I am, because again, I am David Perkins, and I'm actually going to run with that. So we are who we are. I am myself. I am David Perkins, and I do not know how to be anybody else. But there's other adjectives we can apply to ourselves, and there's other affirmations that we can put towards who we are just to promote and generate positivity. You guys know I'm a super positive soul. I like to give nothing but positivity and motivation out to all my followers and to all my subscribers. So I actually created a digital asset. It's a wallpaper that comes in hundreds of different colors and hundreds of different styles just to notate what we are, what I am. I, speaking from you guys, obviously. So just to show you guys one, this comes in an olive green color. Again, it comes in a bunch of different colors, but again, it's a digital asset. You guys can purchase it from me, download by the color. So I'm actually going to sell these through packs. So it'd be a pack of like maybe 8 to 12, and you get a bunch of different colors. But again, it just shows I am on the front. And throughout the whole list is, and throughout the screensaver is a list of adjectives or affirmations that I apply to myself, things I journal about, things that I apply to my daily regimen, or just whatever the case may be. Because again, there's nothing better than speaking positivity into who we are, because that's what generates better energy for the people that we like to support. You know what I'm saying? So again, just a few of them is I am creative, I am consistent, I am positive, I am him, feel me, I'm he, capital H, I am healing, I am strong, I'm handsome, I'm beautiful, I am hardworking, I'm dream chasing, I am choosing wisely, I am still growing, I am always creating. Those are just some of the things on the list that I added to a wallpaper. I added a few of them in a bunch of different colors. I have a bunch of different styles, but again, I'm putting out a digital asset for all my subscribers, all my followers to purchase, which will probably be available next week on my new website. So that's just another way to go ahead and create another stream of income. I want to be able to give as much as I can to you guys just because you guys give me so much support. So again, these will probably be available next week. If you want one and you're watching this video, drop a comment. It'll be available for you. I'll send you whatever color you want. I can make whatever color you want as well. Again, I have them in a bunch of colors. I have them also in a black set. So I created a whole black set. I also created a white set. So again, if you guys want one, you guys can't see the white, but yeah. If you guys want one, I'll send you guys one. If you watch this video, drop a like, drop a comment, send me your email, and I'll go ahead and send you guys one or a pack of whatever, you know, a selection of few. But yeah, so those are my ways to either secure brand new or just create extra stream of income from content creation or as a content creator and influencer. If you guys enjoyed this video, go ahead, drop a like, drop a comment, share, and subscribe to the YouTube channel. We already way past motherfucking 300 subs now. We're coming up on 400 again. So again, the goal is to continue to grow this family. Instagram, I know I mentioned it earlier. I kind of breezed over it, but we broke 25K, bro. I'm at 25.3 thousand followers on Instagram. So I love and I thank y'all again as always. But until the next video, it's your boy Dave, and I'm out.